Yeah. Styling, no. Dissing, but got pictures with me smiling, no. All the things you need, you still want problems, though. All the things I know, I still been silent, though. Yeah. Used to be at Silver City Indigo. Used to be in lunchroom playing dominoes. I don't wanna have to go to funerals. I gotta start sleeping at the studio. I don't have no time to be no Romeo. All the love I need is at the rodeo. All the love I need is here at OVO. Yeah. All the girls I know are there with Ian Tho. Who knows where I end up when that. Maybe it never gets old and that's just how it goes. Last table left in carbone, calling plays on a rotary phone.
Hello everyone, my name is Edwin Hernandez. And today we're going to talk about something that everybody needs, money. We have a special guest. And welcome to Money Matters. Tell me about you.
Hello, my name is Abel Maguire. I'm the owner of the Terraza Industries. When I was a child, my parents didn't have enough money to buy some goods and they prepared this lifestyle. I started to understand the money and how it worked when I was 17.
How do you manage to be so wealthy and became the CEO of Shush at your company?
I like to be alone. I remember in a coffee shop that day.
What was your first micro-enterprise?
A bakery.
Why did you choose that?
Because that's what the parents used to do.
Interesting. Well, now tell us how you became owner and founder of the Terraza Industries.
I've been owning the bakery for a long period. I have a house and take my bread. With the profit, I opened other types of business that we know as a Terraza Industries.
It is very touching and impressive. What advice can you give the audience to start or improve?
You have to be personal, never procrastinate, and learn to save the money. And also, you study the things for a grade.
With all these lessons that Daphne gave us, we have another special guest, but it's not here. Our reporter, Roman, will interview him. Let's see now.
Here with the one and only Javier Cuevas, one of the best technologies that moves the world.
Thank you for inviting me to this special and motivational TV show.
Well, as you can see, my company generates big profits per day. This is because at this time, technology moves the world. Population eat and breathe technology.
Your company promotes?
My company promotes technology that helps the environment. Taking kinetic, wind, or solar energy to convert it into electricity.
Your products?
Like plastic. For example, we have a type of footwear that has an integrated battery when it's charged when walking, converting energy of movement into electricity.
The human being generates kinetic energy that gets lost in the form of heat. On a template that grabs the kinetic energy that is produced with each step. That has a small battery integrated in the shoe.
How much more I have to
go? It is still a prototype, but we hope with 4 kilometers to up the part you're on smart.
To you for having time to follow me. Beautiful. And sunny day.
Hello.
the science section. Electricity engineer, listen to the research.
Hello, I'm the engineer, this is Martinez. I studied electrical mechanics. We are going to talk about electrical circuits. The electricity is very dangerous. We should use the correct protection.
And what type of protection?
The most important of all are the gloves. They isolate your body from the electricity. In turn, electrical circuits can be damaged.
And why we should use the helmets?
If you don't check with the voltage, you really are going to... The voltage is going to push you with an extreme force, and you should protect your head with a helmet.
Well, now that we have the correct or the basic protection, we can start the following process.
Before to start my partners, we're going to explain some concepts of electricity.
The other objects of the house doesn't work. How do you know what is the hard part that doesn't work?
For example, imagine that you have a farm or a park. If you connect the lights in the serial circuit, when you disconnect one of these, every light will stop to work.
And how do you know what is the light that you should change?
There is a reason that we use products in houses and environments.
I'm going to explain the
diagram.
But imagine that this part doesn't exist. Starting with the circuit serial. And this part is a voltage and we have two lights in serial. So if I disconnect one, the other is not working. The parallel is connected to this board.
What I have to imagine that the other circuit doesn't exist?
Because it's only one circuit. But in the switch one control the light one and two in series, and the switch two control the light three and four in parallel.
With this, we are going to summarize everything that we already know. First, we started with knowing the circuit, electric circuits. Then we know about something like the diagram and parallel circuits, and we ended with a diagram that knows us that can be a parallel circuit and a series circuit. And thanks for watching.
According to the newly inaugurated US President Donald Trump, there is a need to build a wall in the Mexican border. In his point of view, these will prevent the entry of immigrants, drugs, and criminals. Watch a little more of this situation on the next video.
Existe un malestar generalizado que ha sido provocado por el muro que quiere construir Donald Trump.
No cabe duda que el daño que provocaría con Estados Unidos, nuestro principal socio comercial, sería significativo. Pero lo que ha monopolizado los comentarios con respecto a la valla son los costos para México.
Y aunque está claro que el muro representa un insulto para los mexicanos, no todo sería negativo. Incluso algunos aspectos podrían ser favorables.
Además, el presidente Donald Trump ha insultado de diferentes formas a México.
But they're killing us economically. They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists.
Diciendo que somos violentos, corruptos y violadores, que México está estafando a Estados Unidos. ¿No será que el presidente Donald Trump se está equivocando y la verdad es que Estados Unidos es quien está estafando a México?
Dado esto, los mexicanos han realizado algunas partes al respecto. Observemos el siguiente.
Quiere construirme un muro Trump
en la frontera.
Tú dices que soy malviviente y criminal, que importo marihuana y solo es nopal. Solo por latino dices que soy sucio.
Ya, este man ya me está haciendo enojar. A todos mis hermanos van a deportar.
Quiere devaluarnos hasta el aguacate.
Él no quiere a los latinos por cruzar el río. No nos quiere de vecinos.
No dejemos que nadie hable mal de México, pero comencemos nosotros también por hablar bien, destacar nuestras fortalezas y construir la marca México.
Lo que sí es una realidad y tiene un impacto negativo para nuestro país es que más allá de que pueda o no implementar sus políticas, lo que sí provoca es mucho nerviosismo en los mercados, que ocasiona una salida justa de nuestro país y deprecia el peso. También, ante un escenario incierto, las decisiones de inversión se difieren y esto afecta al crecimiento económico.
Ahora hablaremos de las ventajas y desventajas tras la salida de México y Estados Unidos del Tratado de Libre Comercio.
Primero que nada recordemos, ¿qué es el Tratado de Libre Comercio?
El Tratado de Libre Comercio es un acuerdo entre los gobiernos de Canadá, Estados Unidos y México para realizar una zona de libre comercio.
Dicho tratado destaca principalmente objetivos a cumplir claramente establecidos en él, tales como
disminuir los obstáculos y facilitar el intercambio fronterizo de bienes y servicios entre las tres naciones.
Cumplir el tratado en cada una de sus condiciones y reglas plasmadas en él.
Competencia honesta y leal entre los países.
Ahora bien, ¿en qué nos afecta y en qué nos beneficia a los mexicanos el rompimiento de este tratado? Este tratado tenía como uno de sus propósitos el generar más empleos en los países para una mejor calidad de vida, lo cual no ha traído el progreso que se prometía cuando se firmó este tratado.
Si bien podemos decir que la economía de México creció, los desempleos han crecido y no solo en México, también en Estados Unidos, y aunque es un tratado imperfecto, por así decirlo,
algunos economistas consideran que el rompimiento de este tratado perjudicaría tanto a México como a Estados Unidos y que provocaría más pérdidas de empleos.
Si vemos desde una perspectiva positiva con la elección de Donald Trump de romper el lazo con México, la caída del peso mexicano a comparación del dólar sería significativa.
Y un país cuya moneda sea mucho menor a la tuya, si nos referimos a la de Estados Unidos con México, este país se vuelve atractivo para los inversionistas, accionistas, incluyendo claramente al sector turístico.
Pero al salirse de este acuerdo transnacional, hace que los acuerdos entre empresas y el intercambio de bienes y servicios se dé con mayor dificultad, lo cual es un punto negativo a considerar, y más si le añadimos la propuesta de levantar un muro en la frontera entre México y Estados Unidos.
Opinamos que si bien las decisiones tomadas pueden no ser de grado para los países involucrados, esta acción representa una nueva posibilidad de México para aumentar su economía, ya que al salir este tratado mejorarán las relaciones económicas y de inversión con otros países, porque a fin de cuentas, si Estados Unidos no quiere invertir y ser un solo socio comercial directo con México,
otros países querrán aprovechar todos los recursos de nuestro país. Algo que resultará positivo también va a ser el hecho de depender en un menor porcentaje de Estados Unidos y comenzar a posicionarse como una potencia económica y turísticamente hablando.
Entonces, lo que Donald Trump logra hacer es despertar el nacionalismo mexicano, que nos une, y así con esto logra convencernos a cada uno de nosotros la grandeza de nuestro país, para que nos dediquemos a construir un futuro en lugar de destruirlo. Y sin duda habrá
más claros que oscuros en nuestro porvenir.
Entonces, hermanos mexicanos, podemos decir
¡gracias, señor Trump!
Thousand people to see what I'm on, yeah. Ducked a lot of spiteful moves. I was the angry you while I was writing views. Saw a side of myself that I just never knew. I probably self-destruct if I ever lose, but I never do. Steady doing double shifts. One to do the beat and I open up like a double click. More blessings because I'm generous. 30-seater plane for like 10 of us. Remember when I bought Sealy the fake Chanel wallet? She knew that shit was a fraud.